A typical start to a sequence of lessons on the particle model might incorporate demonstrations to show diffusion, highlighting that at the smallest scale, particles are always on the move. But diffusion in liquids can be frustratingly slow. Today we'll look at a simple experiment with surprising results that can let students see liquids moving in real time without stirring. At room temperature, particles move with incredible speeds. A typical air molecule between me and the camera right now might be moving in the vicinity of 500 meters per second, and that is of course why the speed of sound in air is so high. But any individual particle is going to bump into others along the way after a short distance and bounce off in some random direction. We talk of it going on a random walk. So with the tiny distance between collisions in a liquid, a solute particle in water will travel only in the region of millimeters per minute. In a long lesson, you can see the purple color from a crystal of potassium manganate 7 making its way through a beaker, but you can introduce some bulk fluid motion by changing the density of the liquid around the dissolving substance. Classically, we do this by heating below the crystal to establish a convection current. The manganate crystal on its own dissolves and diffuses extremely slowly, but when some heat is introduced, the particles nearby begin vibrating faster, occupy, on average, a little bit more volume, the fluid drops in density compared to the surroundings, and it begins to rise, carrying the purple color along with it. A similar effect can be created by changing the density with the addition of a solute. Look at the difference in the way that a drop of food coloring spreads through water when compared with the food coloring on a sweet. The color from the sweet appears to move faster. Different sweets behave in different ways, with the color from Skittles seeming to move faster than the color from M&Ms. Add a few sweets side by side and you would imagine that the colors would mix, but they don't. This allows us to explore the different speeds associated with fluid moving in a given direction and particles moving in a random walk. Lots of effects can be created, but a consistent feature is these clearly defined boundaries between the colors. A clue for what's happening comes from adding sweets side by side with the sweets from an earlier experiment, which have already lost their color. The effect is reproduced, suggesting something else is dissolving along with the food dye. Although it's not clear by looking from above, the whole solution around the sweet is sinking because we're not just dissolving food coloring. We are also dissolving relatively heavy sugar molecules. Here I'm using a fish tank to see the falling solution more clearly, and you can see how I have substituted a random sweet with a sugar cube to really demonstrate that it is the sugar that is carrying the food dye along with it. As the sinking solution reaches the bottom, there's nowhere for it to go but sideways. If two sweet solutions collide, unless one is significantly denser than another, the drive behind the bulk motion will stop and no more mixing will happen until diffusion comes back into play. Now we see how much slower the particles make progress when going on their random walk. Even though the solution is the same temperature as it was moments before, and so the particles should have the same average kinetic energy, it takes a long time for the colors to blend where the sugary solutions have met. Tom Kunzelman gave me the idea to try the fish tank approach, and he used tea bags to suspend his sweets, which will have prevented them falling off the edge like my sugar cube did. However, the sugar cube does dissolve so quickly, it really causes a surprisingly rapid stream of moving fluid. Once you get the idea that the particles are moving, you can play with other variables. What happens with warm water versus cold water? Does the type of sugar play a role? Here I've compared some dextrose tablets with some sugar cubes. I thought that the lighter dextrose molecules might move more slowly or that the colors might appear to mix more readily, but the rate at which the original tablet dissolves is also different. With so many variables you can play with, this doesn't just make for a great demonstration, it can really stimulate ideas for simple but effective investigations. Get more ideas over at ChemEd Exchange, where I enjoy Tom Gunselman's approach to figuring out the secret behind the sweets. And as always, do share with us any cool examples you're able to create. Bye for now.